Hi guys, and welcome to Winnie's 1 year video. Today is her birthday. I don't think she'll let you see her little bandana, but it's my birthday, honey. She's very sleepy. We took her on quite a long walk today down by the river, so she's all very snoozy woozy. But I thought I would do a little update video, just to sort of get to know Winnie at 1 year old. This is kind of like her final milestone marks. So I did a few of her as a puppy, so I will link those or the playlist up in a card. But I thought this kind of would wrap it up quite nicely. Is her 1 year. Yeah. Beefy chops. So I've made some notes. Today's February the 5th, so she is officially 1 year old. You've watched some of the other videos and I may repeat myself slightly on some things, but yeah, like I said, this is just like an overall get to know Winnie. So we were really lucky to find two of her siblings on a Facebook group, like a poodle page. We have found obviously two of her sisters. They don't live particularly close, but I would love to maybe this year towards the summer months do a little meet up with them. I think that would be really fun. So we all said like happy birthday to the puppies this morning. Like I said, we took Winnie on a walk this morning. She isn't the greatest at her walks. We definitely pick our battles with her. We are yet to get her in training, which I know is naughty us probably, for leaving it so long. We really did socialise her quite a bit when she was younger. Like, we took her to cafes and all sorts and took her out as much as we can to like shopping centres and things. But she is really barky when it comes to other dogs. Like, she will just bark at any dog possible. Even like some people, if she takes a particular dislike to them. She's definitely like all bark, no trousers. Like, I doubt she would do anything like to harm them, but pulls on her lead constantly. So the walks are kind of the main issue at the moment. She is 90% of the time toilet trained. Sometimes she will do a wee and like she would have been out like 5 minutes ago in the garden, or like in the mornings if we don't get up like straight away. Like, if we go to put a dressing gown on, she'll run downstairs and have a wee in those like 2 seconds that it's taken to take her outside. So you're gonna sit down. So yes, we're 90% there, but she's still very naughty. I've made some notes, and the one big note I put at the top was, she's a bitch. But she definitely lives up to her fiery little redhead. She likes a chin rub. She's just so like mischievous, and you can tell that she's got this like naughty streak in her. She loves to play with Baloo. Blue's our other poodle, he is 10. Yeah, Blue really tolerates her. They do play a lot, which is lovely to see. They do quite fancy each other as well. They will try and have sauce with each other. They're very unsuccessful. Neither of them knows how to particularly do it, and they always just look like two bears fighting. And any like little clips, videos, photos I can include, I will try to.
No.
Get in your bed. Winnie, in your bed. In your bed. Come on. Bed. In your bed. Bed. They really do love each other. And then at other times she's playing and she can be a right madam and like goes to bite his legs, which is not good because he's at the moment he's got a bit of a muscle problem with his leg anyway. She is a complete daddy's girl. Like, she absolutely loves Darren. If he's sat doing like a night shift, she'll sit with him all night. If he goes out for like 5 seconds, she's sat looking at the door waiting. She's whining now because she's not down there with him. As much as like she loves me, she loves Darren more. But she can be really loving. Like, she will just sit like this and be a little like baby girl and just be really, really cute. And especially when she's sleepy, like she'll just sit like this, like a baby. In the mornings, as soon as she knows that I'm awake, she'll like come up and she'll put her paws right up here on my chest and just like have a little cuddle and want to like lick my face. She still quite likes to lick ears. It's funny because at night she'll go into her own bed and she doesn't like any blankets in her bed. If you put the blankets in, she'll scuff them out. And then at some point in the night she comes in for cuddles. But yeah, she usually is like right up close to Darren. She's sort of moved away from when she was a puppy. She used to sleep right sort of in by my head, but she's kind of moved away from that now. She's really good at being groomed. Like the groomer says, she literally falls asleep on the table. I gave her a little bath earlier after our walk and she just like sat on the windowsill whilst I blow dried her. You were really good, weren't you? Yes, you were. Obviously, we had the little casualty this year where Blue like swiped at her and cut her nose. That's pretty, like, you can see she's got like a little dent, but the colours all come back in her nose because it was quite like pink for a while. But the colours all come back. But yeah, she's really good at like being touched and like being brushed and having her teeth done. So, you know, like I said, we pick our battles there. But yeah, she's good at being left now, especially with Blue. She doesn't whine anymore. But like I said, she will sit there because we've got cameras to watch them. She will just sit there and just like stare at the door until one of us is back. She has a ton of nicknames, which I mean is obviously natural. So obviously her name's Winnie. She was kind of named after Winnie the Pooh. Because we just love Disney, but she gets called like Winnie Woo, Winnie Girl, Winnables, Windsor, Devil Girl, Devil Child, Baby Girl. She still gets called Puppy a lot, even though she's not a puppy anymore. But yeah, I think that's all of like the nicknames that she has. Let me see what else is on my notes. She absolutely loves her nanny and her nana. With my mum, like when I FaceTime her, she sits there and like my mum will do a really high pitched voice to her, and she'll sit there and she'll like turn her head and go, "See nanny, nanny," and she'll like just sit and like watch her and turn her head. So yeah, she absolutely loves my mum. I've put juicy paws because she has the squishiest paws, like they're just so juicy. I've put she loves any toy and will kill it. She doesn't really have a preference on like the type of toy. She usually likes a toy that she can destroy anything with fluff in it. So the toys are on a constant cycle of like having to go in the bin. There's no point like sewing them up anymore. Like with Blue, he would lick his bunnies to death, that he would create holes in them and I would sew them back up, but there's just like no point with Winnie. She is really crafty. If Blue's got a toy that she wants, usually it's a bunny rabbit of some sort, something fluffy, she'll go up. And if I can find the video of her doing it, she'll go up, she'll like roll on her back as if like, "Love me, Blue, I want you to love me." And then like when his guard's down and he's not really paying attention, she'll go and she'll just really slowly like grab the toy and take it away. She is so like, you can just see the clogs working as if like, "I want that toy, I'm gonna get that toy." She is really, really funny. She loves to sleep on the stairs and put her head through the banister. I don't know why, but it's the most hilarious thing. Like, I'll just be sat at the lounge table and I'll turn and look in the hall and she's just got her head stuck right through. And we have these lights as well, like stick-on lights on the stairs, and like sometimes I can tell when she's been sat there because there'll just be one that's been turned on. And she just, she, and I will say, we were really thankful she was never a big chewer of furniture, which is a godsend, because I know at least one of her sisters was. Winnie! Yeah, at least one of her sisters was a definite chewer of furniture and things, but fortunately she's never really been like that, just like a chewer of toys. The only thing she has chewed, and it's usually like in the morning she'll do it when we've given her a breakfast and we've come back to bed and gone to sleep. She'll chew my bras and she'll chew my belts. Like, all of my belts are chewed at the end. I had to put a belt in the bin the other day because it was just beyond keeping. She loves to bite all of my bras, and in fact I think the one I'm wearing has a hole chewed out of it. She's chewed the edge of one of my jumpers. It always seems to be my stuff that she ends up chewing. Darren says it's because I just leave it for her, but don't actively leave it around for her to chew up. But yeah, so like I said, we pick our battles. We're pleased that she was never a particular chewer, scraper. And so I said, she loves Darren. She'll follow him into the toilet. He said she used to, I don't know if she does it so much anymore, she used to go in and she'd sit sort of in behind his trousers and like just lay her head on his trousers while he's sat on the toilet. She'll like sit on the bathroom mat and just wait. She's sat crying because she's not with him.
Hey! Come here.
This is so grumbly.
Oh,
that's so grumbly. But yeah, we couldn't be without her, you know. She's added this little bit of fun and spunk into our lives. Like I said, she's very mischievous, but we love her. She can be really, really loving and adorable. She's always super happy, like, when either of us come home to greet us. We do have to be really careful not to pay her so much attention when we first get back home, because otherwise she'll wee everywhere. And like, she loves to just like roam in the garden. She's constantly asking to go out, and she'd just be outside. We should really install some sort of cat flap for her. She has, from when she stayed at my parents, she's taken a shine to birds. Whenever she sees a bird, she wants to go and get it, which is something she only learned from theirs because they've got quite a big garden. But yeah, we love our little Winnie girl, don't we? Yes. But yeah, so hopefully in the next few weeks we can start getting her into some training. I really, really want to make that a priority. As far as seasons go, we think she's had one season. We're not totally sure. It was whilst we were away, and my mum says it was like two spots. So at some point we need to get her spayed. So since recording this, Winnie has definitely had her first season and we're having to wear little puppy pants. So that one in November was definitely a little trial run. So yeah, we might wait for another season before that happens, because they say like 1 to 2 seasons you should wait. But yeah, she's been on a little play date with her friend Penny, haven't you? Yeah, so we're getting there. Yeah, I think if anything, we just forgot how much sort of effort it was to have a puppy. I think because we had Baloo and he was so good, but obviously we got him when he was 7. He'd already had good manners and things. Is she falling asleep? She's very tired. It's all been too much for her. You've got little doggy birthday cakes later, madam. We'll have to FaceTime the nannies later and let them see you. But yeah, that is Winnie's little 1 year update. And yeah, maybe I will do sort of a Blue update at some point. We've had him now, this will be our 3rd year from rescuing him from Battersea. So yeah, hopefully this year we did the muddy dog run for Battersea last year with Baloo, and I think we did it was just around the time we'd got Winnie, so she was very much still a puppy, hadn't had all her vaccinations and it wouldn't have been suitable for her. So hopefully we can take her on that this year, because I think she'll really love it and get muddy and all that. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video seeing Madam. She actually needs a haircut. She's struggling to see out of her eyes, bless her. She's going in next week for a haircut. Yeah, so yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. Like I said, if you do want to see her other puppy videos, I would have linked the playlist and down below. But yeah, you say goodbye, Winnie. Bye. She's like, let me go and have cuddles, Daddy. We'll see you soon. Bye, guys.
No dog really should be labelled an out and out escape artist. You always have to look at the big picture. Why is the dog looking to escape?
What a good girl.
The house was situated in the middle of...
You're not supposed to have that, madam. Winnie?